So in this video, we are going to discuss the functional area on the cerebral hemisphere. So this view you are seeing, this is the superolateral view of the cerebral hemisphere. In the last videos, we have studied the sulci and gyri. So we have studied this is the central sulcus, divide anterior side with the frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe and the temporal lobe. So these are the four lobes in the cerebral hemisphere. Okay, so the central sulcus is very important. We have studied central sulcus and the lateral sulcus. So the central sulcus will divide anterior side is the full, we have the motor area, and posterior side this area we have the sensory area. So first I will mark the functional area, after that we will discuss about each area. Anterior to the central sulcus you have the area number 4. Area number 4. Anterior to the area number 4, in this region you have the area number 6. Area number 6, and anterior to the area number 6, in this region you have the area number 8. This is the number 8. Then in this area we have the 9, 10 and 11. Okay, so after that, this we have studied already. These are the ascending horizontal and the anterior, ascending and the anterior horizontal we have studied. So this is the area number 44, this is the area number 45. Okay, and below that if you will go, this is the temporal lobe, we have the area number, small area this one, this area, and again in this area we have a little bit this. So we have the area number 41 42, we will discuss in some time. This is the area number 22, this we have studied. And more posterior side if you will go, in this region, we have area number 39 and 40. Okay, if you will go in upper part also, you will see the in the parietal lobe, we will see in this region we have two area posterior to this, like this. This is the area number 5, area number 7. In the occipital lobe side we will come, more posterior side, area number 17, then 18, then 19. Posterior to the central sulcus, in this area we have the area number 3, 1, 3 and 2. So these are the representation in the superolateral view. So these are the main areas we are going to study in the today's video. So don't worry about this, they are very very easy. This is the central sulcus. Anterior to the central sulcus, this is the area number 4. Okay, area number 4, this area is known as the primary motor area. This area is what? This is the primary motor area. So this is the primary motor area. What is the function of this area? It controls the voluntary motor activity of the opposite side of the body. But some part of the body has the bilateral nerve supply, bilateral supply of the upper part of the face, tongue, larynx, pharynx and the extraocular muscles. So these are the some parts they are having bilateral nerve supply. So what is the effect of lesion? If there is a lesion of the area number 4, what will happen? So there will be hemiplegia of the opposite side of the body. Okay, so next you have the area number 6. Area number 6 is also known as the premotor area. This is anterior to the motor, so premotor area. This is known as the premotor area. What it will do? It is responsible for the successful performance of the voluntary motor activity. It means what? It will do programming of the whatever we have studied in the primary motor area. So this will do the programming of the movements of the muscles. So if this area will damage, what will happen? So there will be difficulty in performing the skillful movements if this area will damage. Okay, next we have the area number 8. So just remember, area number 6, it will occupy the posterior part of the superior frontal gyrus, middle frontal gyrus and the inferior frontal gyrus. So it lies in the posterior part of these gyruses. And area number 4 will occupy the posterior part of the middle frontal gyrus. It lies in the posterior most part of the middle frontal gyrus, just anterior to the area number 6. What is the function of this area? Okay, this area is known as what? We have to write first of all. This is known as the frontal eye field. This is what? Frontal eye field. This is the frontal eye field. So what is this function? It will stimulate the, if we will stimulate this region, what will happen? It causes the deviation of the both the eyes on the opposite side, and these movements are known as the conjugate movements of the eye. So if this area will damage, then what will happen? It causes the deviation of the eye to the side of the lesion. Okay, so there will be inability to turn the eye opposite side. You cannot turn the eye opposite side. So next area, whatever area is remaining, 9, 10 and 11, these are known as the prefrontal area. These are what? These areas you are going to see. These areas. This is what? Prefrontal area. So these area will concern with the personality, emotions, social behavior, moral and ethical awareness, and also with the concentration. So if there is a lesion of this area, what will happen? There will be if there is a bilateral lesion, they will cause the change in the personality, loss of concentration, loss of judgment and change in behavior, and person will be careless about anything. So these are the some area we have studied. Area number 4, 6, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Now the area number 44 and 45. So as you can see, this area number 44 lies in the pars triangularis. Area number 44 lies in the pars opercularis. So this area is known as what? This full total. This area is known as the motor speech area. Motor speech area of Broca. Okay, this is the motor speech area of Broca. This area is very very important in case of speech. So it is responsible for the production of expressive speech and the vocalization. And if there is a lesion of this area, it will result in the loss of ability to produce the speech. It means it will lead to the motor aphasia or expressive aphasia. So that's why you should remember this when we are speaking, due to this area only. Okay, motor speech area. Next we are going to discuss about the area in this lobe. So this we have talked about the frontal lobe. Now area number 3, 3, 1, 2. So representation is like this. 3 is there in the middle, then 2, then 1. This area is known as what? Because I told you already, this is the central sulcus. Anterior to the central sulcus, we have the motor area. Behind that, we have the sensory areas. So these are known as the primary. This is the primary sensory area. This is the primary sensory area. This area will concern with the perception of exteroceptive. Exteroceptive means what? Pain, touch and temperature sense, and proprioceptive sensation like vibration, muscle and joint sense. Okay, from the opposite half of the body. And if this area will damage, then what will happen? There will be loss of exteroceptive and proprioceptive sensation from the opposite half of the body. Okay, next area behind that, this will occupy the superior parietal lobule, because this is the parietal lobe. These area are known as the sensory association area. Sensory association area, these two, area number 5 and 7. So this area will concern with the perception of shape, size, roughness and texture of the object. Okay, thus the person is unable to identify the given object in the hand without seeing the object, that is known as the stereognosis. If suppose you are having some object in your hand and your eye is closed, and if you can identify the object, it means your sensory association area is working. Okay, if this area will damage, means there will be loss of the sensation. Next we will talk about the area number 39 and 40. So these are known as what? These are the sensory speech area. These both are what? These are the sensory speech area. These are the sensory speech area. Speech area of Wernicke. Okay, so in the anterior side we have studied the motor speech area. Just posterior side of that we have the sensory speech area. Sensory speech area, if you will see the position, this is the lateral sulcus, posterior most part of the lateral sulcus and posterior most part of the superior temporal sulcus. So this area 39 and 40, sensory speech area of Wernicke. Because motor we have studied already, so this is the sensory area. So it will concern with the interpretation of the language through the visual and auditory input. These are the sensory input, and if this area will damage, it will produce the loss of ability to understand the spoken and written word or written speech, and that is known as the receptive sensory aphasia. It means what? The person will not understand the spoken word. If motor area will damage, means person can understand the words but he cannot speak. Next area we have the area number 22, and first we will discuss this area number. What is this? This is the area number 41 and 42. This area is known as 41 and 42. These are areas known as the primary. This is the primary auditory area. This is the primary auditory area near the, just below the lateral sulcus, 41 and 42. This area will concern with the loudness, quality and pitch of the sound. Can also pick the source of the sound, from where the sound is coming. And if this area will damage, if this will damage unilaterally, there will be slight loss of the hearing. But if this area will damage bilaterally, means complete deafness will be there for the person. Then we have the area number 22. This is known as the secondary. This is the primary we have studied. So secondary auditory area, area or association area. Okay, area number 22. So what is the function? It will receive the auditory impulse from the primary auditory area. Okay, and correlate with the past auditory experiences. And if there is a lesion of this area, area number 22, there will be inability to interpret the meaning of the sound. Whatever he will hear, he cannot interpret the sound, and it may lead to the, there will be experience word deafness. Word deafness will be there, and that is also known as the auditory verbal agnosia. Okay, so this is area number 22. Next we will talk about the area number 17. So this is the area number 17 in the posterior most part of the occipital lobe, and this is known, area number 17 is also known as the primary visual area. This is the primary visual area. So this is the primary visual area. It will concern with the reception and perception of visual impression like color, size, motion, illumination. Okay, so this primary visual area will concern with these all the things. Okay, we can see the different color, size and motions. And if this area will damage area number 17, there will be loss of vision in the opposite visual field. Okay, not on the same side but on the opposite side. Then the area number 18 and 19, just above that area number 18 and 19, these are on the secondary visual area, because primary we have studied, primary is 17, secondary are 18 and 19. These area are responsible for the recognition of the objects seen. Okay, and if there is a lesion of the 18 and 19, it will result in the loss of ability to recognize the object. That is known as the visual agnosia. What is that? That is the visual agnosia. So these are the main functional area in the superolateral surface. Okay, in the medial surface, in the last video we have studied the paracentral lobule, that is the center for the highest center for the micturition and defecation. That also you have to study.